Hey everyone, for today's video, we'll be taking a look at an Intel Z790 motherboard that is targeted at professional content creators, the ASUS ProArt Z790-CREATOR WIFI. Sporting a whole slew of high-end, productivity-oriented features, let's see if this board is any good. Now, in case you're unaware, the ASUS ProArt series of product offerings are targeted primarily at professional content creators. We're talking about the likes of professional graphic designers, filmmakers, and the like. In this regard, the ProArt Z790-CREATOR WIFI comes in a box that sports a black and gold colorway with a minimalist aesthetic that sure looks pretty sleek. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual overview of specs for this board. We'll take a closer look at these specs later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALK Tech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. Opening up the box, we see that the Z790-CREATOR WIFI comes with a Wi-Fi antenna in this box here. With that, let's set aside the board for now to see what other accessories ASUS has included with it. First up, we get a DVD driver disc. And this is accompanied by an ASUS Control Center Express license key. In a nutshell, Control Center Express is a real-time IT monitoring and management application that is targeted at enterprise end users. Apart from this, we do also get the motherboard manual and an ASUS Web Storage promotional offer leaflet. Moving over to this compartment here, we get a DisplayPort cable, a metal ProArt ruler, which I guess is a nice to have. We do also get 4 SATA 3 cables. And these are accompanied by a rubber cover for the screw hole found on the board's rear I/O shield cover. We do also get an ASUS Q connector that simplifies the process of connecting your PC's front panel connectors to the motherboard. A pack of M.2 Q latch attachments, as well as 2 packs of M.2 drive rubber pads that add additional height clearance for users intending to install single-sided M.2 SSDs. With that, onto the board itself. Here it is, the ProArt Z790-CREATOR WIFI. We see that the ProArt brand identity is very much present in the board's aesthetics, where it sports a black and gold colorway that looks pretty sleek. The board comes with an integrated I/O shield design, where we get a translucent plastic shroud with a stylized ProArt text printed onto it, and large black heat sinks all around. Taking a closer look at the rubber screw hole cover included as part of the board's accessories, it fits right into this screw hole opening here on the I/O shield cover. That said, the board doesn't come with onboard RGB LEDs, though it does of course come with a handful of RGB headers. I'll talk about the placement of these headers later on in this video. The VRM heatsinks are pretty large and have a nice curvy design to them, where they help to cool the 16+1 power delivery setup that comes with 70 amp power stages. The board also comes with a passive heatsink for the Z790 chipset that looks really nice, where it has an aesthetic plastic cover that is secured in place by 4 screws. For M.2 drive cooling, ASUS has included M.2 drive heatsinks for all 4 M.2 drive slots that this board comes with, where the 3rd and 4th M.2 slots share a common heatsink. For memory support, the ProArt Z790-CREATOR WIFI comes with 4 DDR5 slots with support for up to 128GB of RAM and the DDR5 7200 standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a single tab design that ASUS calls QDIM. Further down from the RAM slots is a USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 Type-C front panel header that supports Power Delivery 3.0 and the Quick Charge 4 Plus technology, where it can supply up to 60 watts of power to charge devices such as a pen display or tablet. Now, for 60 watt power output to be enabled, you will need to hook up a 6-pin PCIe power connector to this motherboard power header right here. That said, we do also get a USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header, which supports up to 2 front panel USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports. While still on the topic of front panel USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses 2 USB 2.0 front panel headers, with each header providing support for up to 2 USB 2.0 Type-A ports. Moving on to some of the special features that this board comes with, we get a serial port header right here, a thermal sensor header that allows you to connect an optional thermal sensor so as to monitor the temperature of components within your PC case, as well as a TPM header for you to install a TPM module. Moving back up top, another interesting feature that is included are a set of QLEDs that can be used to troubleshoot PC startup issues. We also get a CPU overvoltage jumper that allows you to set higher CPU voltages for overclocking purposes. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with two PCIe 5.0 x16 slots that share bandwidth with each other, where if you have devices installed on both slots, each of these PCIe 5.0 slots will operate at X8 mode instead. Otherwise, the primary PCIe 5.0 x16 slot will operate at full x16 link speeds if there isn't a device installed on the second PCIe 5.0 slot. That said, both PCIe 5.0 slots come with the safe slot feature that reinforces the slot for use with heavy graphics cards, and the primary PCIe 5.0 slot also has what ASUS calls Q-Release. Now, Q-Release is a feature that makes removing a graphics card a painless affair, especially from a completed build. Pressing this button here will undo the Q-Release latch so as to allow the graphics card to be pulled out of the slot with ease. Moving on, we also get a full-length PCIe 4.0 x16 slot that operates at X4 mode. In the storage department, ASUS has included 8 SATA 3 ports, of which 6 of them are in a right-angled configuration and 2 of them in a straight-angled configuration. For M.2 slots, it comes with 4 PCIe 4.0 x4 M.2 slots, of which the 4th slot here also supports SATA M.2 drives. Do note that when you have an M.2 drive installed in this said 4th M.2 slot, SATA ports 5 to 8 will be disabled, as per the screen grab from the motherboard manual. That said, all of the M.2 slots come with the Q-Latch feature, which facilitates the toolless installation and removal of your M.2 SSDs. For audio, ASUS has included a higher-end Realtek S1220A audio codec. In terms of internet connectivity, the board comes with dual Ethernet ports, with one port powered by a Marvell 10 Gigabit Ethernet chip and the other by an Intel i226V chip that serves up 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet. Wi-Fi support, on the other hand, is courtesy of Intel's AX210 NGW Wi-Fi 6E part, which also serves up Bluetooth 5.3 support. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with 8 fan headers that are located in these regions of the board. Also included are 3 addressable RGB headers and a 12-volt standard RGB header located right here. Moving over to the rear I/O, the ProArt Z790-CREATOR WIFI goes for an integrated I/O shield design. The board comes with 2 DisplayPort in connectors, a HDMI 2.1 port that supports display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz, a 10 Gigabit Ethernet port, a 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet port, 6 USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A ports, dual Thunderbolt 4 USB Type-C ports, Wi-Fi antenna connectors, a BIOS flashback button that allows you to update the motherboard's BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM, or graphics card, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. Now, I wanted to spend some time to talk about the support that this motherboard has for professional content creation devices, such as color-accurate monitors, pen display devices, and so on. For instance, the dual Thunderbolt 4 ports on the rear will allow for display output on devices such as a single 8K or two 4K color-accurate monitors, and so on. For example, to enable video output on the Thunderbolt 4 USB Type-C 1 port, you'll need to use the bundled DisplayPort cable to connect the DisplayPort output port of your graphics card to the DisplayPort in 1 port of the motherboard, and thereafter, use a Thunderbolt 4 USB Type-C cable to hook up your display device to the Thunderbolt 4 USB Type-C 1 port, as per these photos from the ASUS website. There's a whole bunch of other connection permutations available, where more details can be found in the motherboard's user manual, like so. In conclusion, the ASUS ProArt Z790-CREATOR WIFI is a full-fledged Intel Z790 motherboard that comes with plenty of features targeted at professional content creators. It has a classy-looking aesthetic, good VRM setup that's great for high-end Intel 13th generation CPUs, dual PCIe 5.0 slots for graphics cards, 10 Gigabit Ethernet, a good audio codec, and more importantly, a whole host of USB connectivity options with dual Thunderbolt 4 ports. As of end February 2023, this board is available to purchase in Singapore for a price of around 756 Singapore dollars from offline and online retailers in Singapore, or for you international viewers, around 444 US dollars from e-commerce sites such as Amazon. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.